Hello friends, welcome to the tutorial 2 of COMSOL Multiphysics. So in tutorial 1 we have shown you how to model a pipe flow by using COMSOL Multiphysics. And what COMSOL Multiphysics basically is, we have also taught you in the last class. In this section I will teach you another fluid mechanics problem, that is a Coet flow. So before going to the modeling of Coet flow, let us know what Coet flow basically is. The Coet flow in this particular problem, what we do, there are two plates, and suppose a liquid of high viscous liquid is placed in between the two plates, and the upper plate will move with a certain velocity keeping the lower plate static. So this particular thing is called Coet flow. So we'll be modeling this particular problem. So to do that, we go to model wizard, just click on model wizard, and then take 2D, because we'll be solving in 2D. And you see here so many modules are coming, and out of that I click on fluid flow, I expand it, and in this fluid flow I expand again the single phase flow and take the laminar flow physics. And just click on add. The physics has been added to the interface, and then we have to choose our study. It will be a unsteady state problem, so we choose time dependent one and just click on done. You see here the main page has come. So like the previous one, we will choose our geometry initially. So just right click on geometry, take rectangle. One more thing I want to show you, see here geometry option is there. You can see also other the same option is here also. If you click on here, then you will see the same options are coming in this place. So you can choose from here also, and also by right clicking on geometry. Now let me keep the unit in centimeter, then we have to put the dimensions. Say the width is 5 and the height is 1 centimeter itself. Just click on build selected. So you see this is the domain where we'll be solving our problems. Now I need to add material, so just go to material, just right click on it, add material. I can choose the recent materials. Water has already been there, so just click on water and add it. So the water has come and it is in this domain by default. Now I go to laminar flow. I need to define my inlet and outlet. So right click on laminar flow, choose inlet. Again right click, choose outlet. I need to add one more wall. I'll tell you why. So let me keep the velocity inlet condition as pressure is 0. Those are nothing but the boundary conditions, and outlet also the pressure is 0. Now I define my wall. Wall 2 means the moving wall. If I click on here, the wall has been selected, and let me put it as a moving wall. So if it is a moving wall, it is asking for the velocity with which it is moving. Let me keep it 0.01 meter per second, and this wall is automatically by default no slip. Okay, I have not chosen my inlet outlet. This is the inlet and that is the outlet. Now everything is done. I'll show you, these are the equations we are solving, as we have solved for pipe flow. Then we go for meshing. Just click on build all, because normal mesh is quite good enough for this simple problem. Then go to time dependent, we solve it for say 5 seconds. Just click on compute. Yeah, the simulation has started. You can see here the time steps are coming, it is simulating. Here out means it has solved the data at 0.1 second, then 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, like that. That is why this out coming, because I have chosen this 0.1 as my time step. So the simulation has already over. So you can see here at the wall which is moving, the velocity is maximum and then it is diminishing. If I want to plot the velocity profile along this transverse direction, just I go to data set, right click on data set, take 2D cut line 2D, and cut line 2D, say I want to see the velocity at this particular place. So let me keep my x 3, 0.2 is also 3, y is going from 0 to 1. Just click on plot. So this is plotted, and then just go to result, right click on it, take 1D plot group. In 1D plot group, put the data set cut line 2D1, time selection, you can, I want to plot for last time step, that is 5 seconds. Again right click on 1D plot group, take line graph and just plot it. So you can see here how the velocity is diminishing. It is at the moving wall, the velocity is maximum 0.01 meter per second, the boundary condition which we have taken initially, and then it is diminishing and going to zero at the static wall. Now if I want to see the development with time, I have to plot it for all the time steps. Just let me plot it. You can see how the profile is growing and it is going to the steady state. This is basically unsteady state problem, so with time it is developing. So this is basically increasing time. Okay, thank you for watching.